The finale, we've been working for it our whole lives. All of us have been playing together for so long. And we've just been thinking about it forever. Obviously, we're missing a few guys, but I still think we want it too bad. We want it more than them. So I think we're gonna pull through with it. Hopefully we can get Panucci on the field. He's got a bit of a bum ankle, but he's got nothing else to lose.
Tewksbury and Reading can both play with anybody in the state.
Absolutely. They're both two of the best teams in the state. I don't care what division it is. The face-offs will be a challenge today.
And it's competitive and picked up by Tewksbury. That's Braden Hewlett. Ball turns over. Evan Panucci for Reading. Got it into the offensive end, and it's picked up by Martin Boyle. Loads up right-handed, shot top left corner, and getting a piece of it was Finn Granara.
Yeah, got a piece of it, sure.
I think a defender got a stick on his stick, and that...
Great defensive stand.
Granara one-handed, loads up lefty, and scores! Remy Granara with the goal, the first goal of the game, and Reading breaks on top. 1-0 with just under 5 minutes to go in the first quarter.
Robbie kind of broke the ice by getting that first goal, which was huge.
Filipski, number 10, the pole, defending on Valarin, and...
Wow.
Couldn't get it in the box. Great defense there by Reading. Just one-on-one defense. The pole on the pole.
Stood on their heads in that first or the first quarter, holding them to zero goals. So it was 2-0 going into the second.
Feed in front of a great save by Granara.
What a save!
That should get the fans into things here with 8:40 to go in the first half and a 2-0 lead for the Rockets.
Tewksbury plays unbelievable, gets two great shots on net, and Granara comes standing on his head.
Can't bring it down, and now Braden Hewlett does. Braden Hewlett with a sidearm underhand lefty. Lets it fly, and he gets tattooed, and the flag flies.
Coming up, Reading.
Will Sovic can't come up with it. Right in, the score is Boyle! And a flag flies!
Man down goal, Reading.
Boyle set up by Cullen Granara.
Wow.
Yep. Thank you. It's gotta be a flag. Santrella finds Granara open. Granara loads up and this time scores. Almost the same shot.
Unbelievable.
And Santrella makes, or rather, Granara makes it 4-0.
And that one he did an over top, overhand rip. Granada's got it all. He's got all the tools in the toolbox.
Reading goal scored by number 22, Robbie
Granara. We'll go to halftime with Reading leading it 4-0. Two goals by Robbie Granara, one by Nate Mulvey, and one by Mark Boyle. And Duxbury unable to solve goaltender Finn Granara in the first 24 minutes.
End of the first half, we go man down. We stay man down for a while. We actually went two man down for a big portion of that. The man down had been definitely a weaker point of our team. We were getting scored on a lot more. We were taking too many penalties all playoff long. I was kind of thinking the worst of that situation. But defense came up big. Everyone did their job. And we actually ended up getting, I think it was two turnovers on that. And one of them ended up leading to a goal, which put us up by even more going into the half and kept them scoreless.
And loose and coming up Reading.
Reading, Stroud. And they get it up to Nate Johnson. Bit of a fast break, Granara to Boyle, wide open in front, Kelly Granara from Mark Boyle.
What ball move by Reading. Looks like they changed up their ride a little bit. And it looks like it gave Duxbury some trouble. And next thing you know, fast break Reading, goal.
Nobody moving really in the scoring area. Now feed into the middle, and Hewlett goes up top, wow. And he's stymied there. Terrific defense by Ian Leonard. Granara to Mealy. Leonard lets him know he'll stay onside. Boyle now, nice dance. Boyle over the top, has an open man. It's Koster, shot to score, Eden Koster! With the bounce shot that bounced closer to the cage, and all of a sudden it's 6-0. Wide open man, Santrella, and he scores! Now feed in the middle, and a shot to score, and now Koster has a couple on a beautiful pass from Colin Granara. Nice pass and another great save by Granara. Finn Granara.
Here it is.
Wide open in front. Kelly Granara from Robbie Granara.
Granara just has a magnet in that stick for the ball. Moves it off the ground. Another goal Reading. Just beautiful across. Beautiful.
Home Granara. Final goal, 2 minutes, 43 seconds.
Day. Pikel now will jog near side. He draws Leone as he has a lot of today. Down to 2 minutes in the third quarter. Pikel trying to go on Leone. Pikel now draws Peely for the double. Pikel goes up the shoot, is knocked out of his stand. So after three here in the D2 championship, it is is unbelievably running 9 and Duxbury 2. We'll take a quick break and be back with the fourth quarter, starting with a Duxbury man up.
That's the end of the third quarter with the score Reading 9, Duxbury 2.
And then to open up the third, we went on another big run. I forget what that score, what we made it, but Koster had one, Mark had another one, and it was just pure domination. And I think it wasn't over at the start of the third, but there was a feeling that there's no way that we're losing this game. We're the better team. We want it more than them. You could definitely feel the nerves. The Tobins talked to us, and they kind of ran us through and said, like, we have a chance to make history today. Like, do what they did. And I remember watching them win it all, and I've always wanted to do what they did.
Love, love, standing by the window, questioning if daddy's ever going to show up. Isn't something he's gonna have to worry about. Don't get it twisted, that was in the shot. Mama, I forgive you, I just don't want him to grow up thinking that he'll never be enough. 30 years of running, 30 years of searching, 30 years of hurting, 30 years of pain, 30 years of fearful, 30 years of anger, 30 years of empty, 30 years of shame, 30 years of broken, 30 years of anguish, 30 years of hopeless, 30 years of hey, 30 years of never, 30 years of maybe, 30 years of later, 30 years of fate, 30 years of hollow, 30 years of sorrow, 30 years of darkness, 30 years of pain, 30 years of baggage, 30 years of sadness, 30 years of stagnant, 30 years of change, 30 years of patience, 30 years of suffering, 30 years of torment, 30 years of pain, 30 years of bitter, 30 years of lonely, 30 years of pushing everyone away. You'll never evolve. I know I can change. We are not enough. We are not the same. You don't have the heart. You don't have the strength. You don't have the will. You don't have the faith. You'll never be loved. You'll never be safe. Might as well give up. Not running away. You don't have the guts. You're the one afraid. I'm the one in charge. I'm taking up. I'm taking up.
Reigns.
The second half of the game was a lot of the same. They put in a few goals. Our defense had a few breakdowns, but it was too little too late for them.
Your final score, Reading 9, Duxbury 4. Reading Rockets, the Division 2, state champion.
When that final buzzer sounded, I mean, it was the best feeling in the world.
Seeing everyone throwing their helmets, their gloves, and going out and jumping around, acting like idiots, it was amazing. I mean, we dominated the game from start to finish. Our defense played unbelievable. Finn, 16 saves or something like that, just the complete backbone of our team.
Threw my helmet up, I threw my gloves up. It was the most relieving feeling, and to finally feel that accomplishment that we finished the story. Just to be in that group together, all huddled up, and to finally just be able to like look at each other and think like, we did it.
And Reading Memorial High School wraps up an epic season, 22 wins and one loss, the only loss coming to BC High, who will be in the Division One game.
Post-game on the bus, it was really, really rowdy. Everyone was passing around the trophy and kissing and whatnot. The ride home, we got a police escort and we got the whole town to line up waiting for us to come in and cheer us on, which was awesome. I was holding the trophy out the window with one hand, which Coach already was telling me, he's like, get that in here. And I was like, yeah, I'll bring it in. Kept it out the window the whole time.
State championship, Eamon Centrella, Aiden Coster, big games from both of them.
They've got the biggest.
Eamon, what'd you think?
Finn Gennaar is the best goalie in the state by far. Stands on his nuts game after game. We have a huge fucking win. Coster stepped up, everyone stepped up. We brought another fucking ring back to Reading, and we're gonna celebrate tonight.
That game, hey, that game could have been close, but we have the best goalie in the goddamn league.
And it's
Eamon Centrella's graduation party actually fell on the same day of the game. So that was interesting, to say the least. It was pretty rowdy. There was, felt like the whole town was there. Eamon actually had a karaoke machine at his party, which was real fun. And right towards the end, the lacrosse team was supposed to go to Robbie's house, and someone hopped on the mic and said Robbie's address. So everyone found their way over to Robbie's house. It was the best 20-minute party there was until the feds broke it up. But it was fun while it lasted.
For the Reading Rockets senior class, the final buzzer has sounded. They set a goal back in middle school to become state champions. Together, they made this dream a reality. As the weeks, months, and years go by for these state champions, an understanding will grow in their hearts that it was always the journey and not the destination.
Yeah. This is the end of the documentary.